Today I'm going to talk all about how to set up and personalize your chart of account in QuickBooks Online. Hey, my name is Morgan from FinePoints.biz, and I am a bookkeeper who loves to help you organize your business. Definitely give this video a thumbs up if you're excited for the chart of accounts, and subscribe to my channel for a new video every single Tuesday. So hopefully you've been enjoying my series on bookkeeper basics. So first I talked about what does a bookkeeper do, I talked about the very first step you need to starting a bookkeeping business, and now I'm going to dive into QuickBooks Online a little bit more and talk about the chart of accounts, because it really is the backbone of the work you're doing as a bookkeeper. So it's all the accounts, all the categories you're using as a bookkeeper. And there are some complexities to it in terms of there's different types of accounts. There's equity, there's income, there's expense accounts, there's bank accounts, there's all these different accounts. So you really need to have a firm understanding of the chart of accounts as a bookkeeper. And then part of my favorite thing is to kind of tweak the chart of accounts to make it really personalized for each individual client. And just the way my brain works, like I love organizing all of those categories and laying them out in a way that makes really good sense and really helps the business owners get a picture of their business and where they're spending their money. So we're going to jump over to my computer screen, and I'm going to talk about just what is the chart of accounts. I'm going to talk about subaccounts and how to use those. I'm going to talk about how to choose a different chart of accounts per industry and how many accounts you have. Like, should you be sorting them out by each vendor, or should you kind of clump things together? So let's go over to my computer screen. All right, so right here is the chart of accounts with a whole bunch of different account types. And before we even get into this, I'm going to show you what it looks like on the profit and loss statement that you are going to send to your clients, just so you can know kind of where the things are going. So I just switch over to reports. Let's go to standard profit and loss. And there's a bunch of different kinds of reports you can run, but let's just do this year totals only, and we'll see how this business is looking. So you can see at the top is all the income they have. This is a construction company, so they have different kinds of income for, it looks like, for designing things, and then they have landscaping services they do, so they kind of broke out some of their different types of income. And then you can see the total income is right here. It is $10,000. And then below that are all the expenses. So this is the cost of goods. So everything that they spent on, probably lumber or whatever supplies they needed. And then here are all their other things. So here's how much they spent on their bookkeeper, accounting and office expenses. So everything, all of these things right here, these categories are what are in the chart of accounts. And you have complete control over, how this is listed. Within the expenses, for example, you can shrink this down so you just see the total for legal and professional fees, and you don't see everything under there, so you have control over that. These are called subaccounts, which I'm going to get into in a little bit. And then, of course, at the very bottom of the profit and loss is the bottom line. So this is how much the business is making. This is for the whole year. So this business has made $1,600. And then from the profit and loss statement, you can click into any of these to see what is in each category. So they just spent $900 on their rent last month. And for the automobile, they're spending a little bit here and there. It looks like they're getting their car wash. You need to check with your tax preparer to see if you can discount or if you can deduct that. Okay, so this is where everything is going within the chart of accounts. This is why we're going to be changing the chart of accounts. All right, so to find the chart of accounts, you want to go to accounting and then chart of accounts. And then this has kind of the baseline of everything that you are working with within QuickBooks, most of the stuff in here. So you can see it's pretty extensive, and all of these things came with, when I signed up for QuickBooks, they were all already in there. I didn't have to create all these things. And the first thing I want you to notice is the type. So this is very important. We have bank accounts to start out with. So that is just what it sounds like, your checking account, your savings account. Maybe you have a credit card, maybe you have a couple checking accounts, maybe you have different money in different, banks. All of those should be labeled as a bank account, actually not a credit card, that is down here under credit card. But anything that's a bank account, you want to make sure it's labeled as that, because that will help QuickBooks know how it functions. All right, I'm not going to go into detail about every single type of account, but there's current assets, fixed assets, so anything that your business owns that has value are assets. Accounts payable is money that you owe, so bills that you need to pay for other vendors. Credit cards is just what it sounds like. And other liabilities are things that you owe to people, so loans. Equity is any money that you are putting into the business. So as an owner, if you're taking out like a salary or an owner's draw, that is equity that you are removing from the business. So it's not actually a business expense. It is a different type of account, as well as maybe when you started your business, you put, you know, a couple hundred dollars or $1,000 or $2,000 into the business of your own personal expenses. So that would be equity as well. All right. And then the main two types of accounts we work with in QuickBooks is income accounts and then expense accounts. So you can see all of these income accounts came with this thing. So you can, as a business, you can have a lot of different types of income. So this particular business in the sample company, I believe is, it's landscaping. So they want to track, you know, how much they make for decks and patios, how much they make for gardens and plants and all these different types of income they have, they want shown on their profit and loss statement. And realistically, in most of my clients, I only use a couple types of income. I don't like to get it overly complicated. I talk with them kind of about what their business looks like and what they need and what they need to track within their income, and then just go with that and make it as simple as possible. There's cost of goods and then expense accounts. So this is the majority of what you're going to be working with. And these are right now in alphabetical order, and they are 100% customizable. So if you don't want it to say advertising, if you want it to say something else, marketing, you can change that. You can change the wording. You can change how these, when it's indented like this, it's a sub account. So on the profit and loss statement, which I'll show you in a little while, the fuel is going to show up under automobiles, which makes logical sense, right? And then again, the job materials, here's all the different types of job materials. So that's going to show up under the main heading of job materials. And then it looks like they even have that set up under job expenses. So job expenses is kind of like a big category, and then they have it broken up after that. So anytime you want to change any of these, you can go to edit, just click on that little drop down and then edit. So instead of job expenses, I want to say service expenses. You can change that. So then it says service expenses. And then you could also change your, what is a subheading. So right here, this is a subaccount of service expenses. If I want to make it a service or a subaccount of something else, a subaccount of supplies, which doesn't make sense, but I can do any of that changing right here for the subaccount. So you can make it however you need to. And then you can also use this button at the top if you want to mass edit a bunch of things, use that little pencil thing, and then you can change wording on any of this. So sometimes I'll put little notes, like there's different kinds of travel meals you can have. So sometimes I'll have two categories of that, and maybe I'll put 100%, like this is, these are meals that are deducted 100%. So which would be like office, big office parties, like your Christmas party and stuff that everyone's invited to. So I can just put notes. You can change anything that you want to be very business specific. You can delete these if you want to. So I'm gonna, I guess I'll save that. And I'll show you what happens if you wanna delete it. Most of the time you have to make it inactive. So let's delete decks and patios. Say we stopped deciding to do decks and patios. So you make it inactive and it says, yes, you want to make this inactive. So then it won't show up as an example when you're categorizing expenses. So it won't, you won't be able to select it on any new things. The only time it's going to show up is if it is like in a past transaction. So if you've already used it this year, then it will show up on your profit and loss statement. And then it doesn't show up here unless you say include inactive accounts, then that one would show up. And then I believe typically when you start your QuickBooks account, when you set this all up for your client, it asks you what type of business they have. So if they have a service-based business or if they have, you know, a construction company, and then it will customize the chart of accounts somewhat to different types of businesses. I'm not sure how many options there are, but that will at least give you a head start. So you're not going to have ones that totally don't apply, and you know, hopefully they'll somewhat match the type of business you have. And I think a lot of times it's good to start categorizing things, get to know your client's business before you go totally changing everything in here, just because you want to make sure it's going to make sense. And like I said, I like to keep things as simple as possible. So a lot, like for utilities, for example, a lot of times people will have, you know, all their utilities broken out, gas and electric, telephone,
internet, like everything that they need under utilities, water. Another way to do it that might be more simple, depending on the business, is just label everything as utilities. Then when you go into this, it'll just be all the utilities grouped together. But if you want to run up a report to see how much your gas and electric was, you can always just pull it by vendor if you have the same vendor every time, like PGE, that's always your gas bill or something. So I don't know, you might think it's crazy to put everything under utilities, but really think about your client's business and do they need to know like monthly basis how much they spend for each of these things? Or is it okay just to be like, okay, your monthly utilities are like $1,000 and then, you know, you hit that this month. And then you can run reports on any of these. So if I click on utilities, it'll show me within here, you know, how much I spent in each of these things in the totals. All right, so that is an overview of the chart of accounts, a really important cornerstone of QuickBooks Online. So let me know in the comments if you guys have any questions and if there are any other areas of QuickBooks Online that you want me to focus on and do some more tutorials or overviews.
Thank you guys so much for watching this video about the chart of accounts. Hopefully it was helpful. Make sure to leave any questions you have down in the comments below, as well as let me know how you're doing in your bookkeeping business. Are you just getting started? Are you a seasoned bookkeeper who is looking for more in-depth tutorials from me? Let me know what you're looking for. And don't forget, a thumbs up is a huge compliment for me, and stick around for my next video next Tuesday. Take care.